Hey guys, how's it going? This is Steve with All Dogs Off-Road, and on today's video, we're going to be talking about our AAL-Leafs and how to install them onto your leaf pack. So we have two different AAL-Leaf offerings, or three actually. First one is going to be the Nissan Xterra AAL-Leaf, which is a three-blade AAL-Leaf, and then our Frontier and Tacoma AAL-Leaf, which is also three blades, but it's a little bit longer just due to the fact that the leaf packs are longer than the Xterra leaf packs. This leaf pack right here is from a 2007 Nissan Frontier, I believe. One of the leaves is actually cracked, so the owner went with a full replacement leaf pack rather than add a leaf, but we have it in the shop, so I'm gonna use it for this example. So the tools that you're gonna need are gonna be the following. A C-clamp, some sort of pliers. I'm using vice grips here, but you know, channel locks, pliers, whatever, all will work fine. And 14 millimeter wrenches. For this video, I'm gonna be using air tools just to make it quick, but absolutely not necessary. Hand tools will work just fine. So let's get started. Our AAL-Leafs are designed to be used and remove the overload leaf from the leaf pack. The overload leaf is this big fat leaf on the top or on the bottom that prevents your leaf pack from going inverted. Without the overload leaf, you will gain more articulation off-road and it should ride a little bit better for you. You can, if you do a lot of hauling and towing, you can keep the overload leaf, but you'll get a little bit more lift out of it and you'll suffer a little bit of articulation. But completely up to you, but if you do choose to keep it, there is some stuff that we need to do, which we'll go over in a second. So the first step is, you know, you rip it out of your vehicle, you have it here. We're going to remove this center pin here and remove this clamp from the leaf pack. So this clamp goes from the overload leaf up top of the main leaf and holds the pack together to stop it from peeling apart when you drip your truck. In order to get that off, there's gonna be an Allen wrench that you need to undo that, but this is so seized up that we are going to use our cutting tool for that. Just to make it quick. So I'm gonna knock that out super quickly, and then we'll be right back. All right, now that the clasp is taken care of, we can now rip out the center pin. So one thing to be careful of is that when you zip this apart, it is under a little bit of tension, but not too much. So be aware of that so it doesn't, you know, blow up in your face. But it's gonna be a 14 millimeter. So let's yank this down. So one thing that's happening here is this top nut is turning, but the bottom center pin is rotating in place. So just, you know, grab a pair of pliers or whatever and grab a hold of it and then zip it off. Voila. Sweet. So now you can lift the pack up and off, and you now have your overload leaf separated from the leaf pack. So here's your fat overload leaf, and we're gonna ditch that. Okay, so next, we have this disgusting leaf pack, and I'm gonna try to adjust the camera so you can see it a little bit better. Okay, so now that we have this, you have your AAL-Leaf, and we're going to want to pull off these side clasps, and then the center pin. The center pin we'll want to do last. Center pin out. And lastly, middle center pin. Alright, so the same thing's happening. So just grab some pliers. Grab there. And zip it right off. So this sleeve you can just chuck, throw away, you don't need it. So the center pin is going to be the new center pin for your leaf pack, but let's just turn this upside down. And remember, so the sticker on here is going to go forward. So we lay it down just like that. And we grab our center pin and we work it down on through until we get all the way down just like that. So boom, you now have a 6-leaf leaf pack instead of a 3-leaf leaf pack. So the last step here is to throw a C-clamp on and preload this down. And then we're gonna grab this, switch directions, and zip this on up. If you're using air tools, it's extra important to get it started before you zip it all the way up. Voila! Congratulations, you have successfully installed an All Dogs Off-Road 3-leaf Attaleaf. The last step is to merely throw on these guys onto the clamps here, and you're good to bolt it back onto the truck. Hope you guys learned something. Thanks for watching. This is Steve with All Dogs Off-Road, and I'll see you in the next video.